Now, a never-before-seen video and chilling new audio dominated day two of President Trump's second impeachment trial. Congresswoman Stacey Plaskett, who once served as an assistant DA in the Bronx, presented a detailed timeline of events and evidence accusing President Trump of inciting a riot.
That is a mob that was sent by the President of the United States to stop the certification of an election. The Vice President, the Speaker of the House, the first and second in line to the presidency, were performing their constitutional duties, presiding over the election certification, and they were put in danger.
Emotions ran high as prosecutors made a compelling case for impeachment, which they will resume today at noon. So we are joined this morning by political analyst Basil Smikle and Chapin Fay to walk us through it all. Good morning to both of you.
Morning.
Morning.
So I want to begin with you, Basil. Let's first talk about the arguments laid out yesterday. The video was just so damning. How is that argument and case going now for the House impeachment managers?
Well, they're very strong arguments, as you indicated. I mean, the video was highly emotional. When you see the vice president being escorted or rushed out of the building, you see Mitt Romney being escorted or saved, if you will, by that Capitol Police guard who had engaged in so much heroic behavior that day. So it's incredible testimony that I think the senators may not respond to it, but the Americans certainly are.
Yeah, Basil, I think we actually lost your shot there, so we'll try to get that back for a second. But Chapin, what exactly is your takeaway from all of the tweets? We just saw that video, the testimony, the video of the speeches. We just saw that video of Senator Schumer being escorted out and then running down the hallway. Still this morning, Republicans are saying it is not enough to convince them to impeach the president. What do you make of all that?
Well, I mean, the video, like Basil said, the emotions are running high. Americans are certainly seeing it. There's some video we haven't seen before. It's jarring. It's horrible. It was one of the worst days in American political history, for sure. And that's why, we're having a trial. There's supposed to be, some dispassionate justice being meted out. The real issue, though, is that it's a political trial. It's not a legal trial. Impeachment trials are inherently political. And the country is highly politicized. So this is turning Republican, Democrat. And, much like the Bill Clinton impeachment trial, it really rests on how popular the guy on trial is in these senators' home districts. And if Trump is popular in their home districts, they're going to vote for acquittal, regardless of what kind of videos we see. It may not be good or right for or good for America, but that's just how the process is playing out.
But at the core of this, right, Chapin, at the core, they're supposed to be impartial jurors looking at the evidence presented to them. That's why you saw Senator Lisa Murkowski actually come out yesterday and say that the case is being laid out very clearly. The dots are being connected. We have some of that from Lisa Murkowski. I want to play it for you.
I wasn't fully aware of everything else that was happening in the building. And so when you see all the pieces come together, the just the total awareness of that, the enormity of this, the threat, not just to us as people, as lawmakers, but the threat to the institution and what Congress represents, it's disturbing.
So do you think, Chapin, that we'll see some Republicans move over to vote to convict?
I think you will. And, based on my earlier point about it being political, I think some of the strongest arguments are going to be from Republican senators like Senator Murkowski, because this is Republican-Democrat. That's how the Senate works. That's how politics works. I know this process, people want it to be legal and judicial and, dispassionate and not political, but it is. There's no getting around it. So I do think the arguments from Republican senators like Senator Murkowski will carry a lot more water than some of the, partisan Democrats who are making the case.
And, of course, the key number is 17 to get over. Basil, we also learned just how heroic Officer Eugene Goodman's actions were in the midst of all the chaos of the Capitol. We just saw that video there. He got Mitt Romney out of danger, told to turn around and run away from the rioters who had made it their way inside. He's now one of these six GOP senators who broke with the Republican ranks, right? We also saw a new video of Mike Pence being evacuated as well. Basil, what is happening on Capitol Hill right now? Behind closed doors, are Senate Democrats trying to whip together votes to try to get to Chapin's point, more Republican senators to change their minds?
Well, I don't think they would be doing their jobs if they weren't trying to do that. But to Chapin's point earlier, you know, you have a lot of you have a lot of senators up for re-election in 2022. So it's a highly politicized process. They're trying to weigh whether or not taking a stand to convict this president is going to have electoral ramifications for them in the coming year, donor ramifications in the months leading up to that. And so, you know, where Democrats certainly are trying to make their case, they're going to continue to make it today and focus more on the lawmakers and the staff. And maybe that will elicit a more emotional reaction. But, you know, it's going to be difficult, if not impossible, to convict this president based on what we know now. The key is to, A, keep him from running for president again, mm-hmm. and B, I think, hold both the president and the Republican senators accountable for when they do run for re-election next year, to ask the question, where were you when you had an opportunity to hold this president accountable?
Real quick, we're out of time. I want to get both your reactions on this. Just keep your answers brief, please. Basil, begin with you. Your President Trump's team, the legal team, watching all of this, what is your argument?
My argument is I wasn't there. I had nothing to do with it. That's a tough argument to make. It won't hold any water.
Chapin?
Yeah, I think that's what they're going to say. You know, he's got a First Amendment right to say whatever he wants, and what people do based on that is their issue, and they're the ones that should be on trial. Again, hard argument to make.
Understood. Chapin, Basil, we'll see how this all plays out. Another busy day ahead beginning at noon today. Thank you both for your voice.